mortgage payment with today's 15-year fixed refi at 1.875% rated APR with no closing costs. None. Zero. Even if you've refinanced recently, call 855-5-ONING and let us crush your monthly payment even more. That's 855-5-ONING or log on to owning.com.
NMLS 2611, licensed by the Department of Financial Protection and Innovation under the California Residential Mortgage Lending Act, subject to credit approval. Call 823-852-6464 for terms and conditions.
You can crush it too with a 15-year fix, 1.875% rated APR, with absolutely no closing costs.
I feel incredible because I called 1-800-WEST-MEDICAL.
Live.
KFI AM 640.
Local.
And I'm a radio station.
When you're checking the TV addict, you're the dopamine to bring static. When you clean up in your grandma's house, grab your back street friend to get loud.
KFI AM 640, live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app. Good morning. It's the Bill Handel Show. He is recovering from heart valve replacement surgery. We will have an update on his situation at 9 o'clock. Well, do you remember when Governor Andrew Cuomo of New York would come out with all those news briefings in the early days of the pandemic? Seemed like every day he would come out, monopolize the airwaves, talking about how awesome he was at dealing with the pandemic. And there were all these aides and staff people who would be there, except for one. There was one person who you might think would be there at all of them who wasn't. Kathy Hochul, the lieutenant governor. That's weird. Also, Cuomo put that book out about how great a pandemic guy that he is. And the title of that book is eluding me at this point. Oh, it's is it American Crisis Lessons from the Pandemic or something like that? So he put a book out about how great he is, and he also gave a lot of praise for how other people in his administration helped him be so awesome at a pandemic. No mention of his lieutenant governor, Kathy Hochul. And you might think, oh, I bet she's bummed. She's getting marginalized by this guy. Probably not now. She's probably so happy that he froze her out and kept her at arm's length. Because now, she's getting ready to be the next governor of New York. And it's going to be a lot easier for her. Because nobody's going to be able to go, oh, look at this when you were so chummy with him. And look at this when you were so chummy with him. Because there isn't any of that. And Cuomo's not going to be the governor for that much longer. They're already pursuing impeachment action in the legislature. You've got multiple DAs around the state have opened criminal investigations. And CBS this morning is running an interview with one of his accusers, you know, who has come forward and sat down for a big, long interview talking about all the terrible things that he did. And then we just saw that his top aide, Melissa DeRosa, stepped down. And she was one of the people who was one of his most ardent defenders. And she would go after people, apparently. Someone would complain, and she would go after them. He even called her one of his mean girls. She's all over the Attorney General's report on Cuomo. It's about 168 pages of report, and Melissa DeRosa's mentioned like 180 times. And she's now stepped down. My point is, she was possibly his most dogged defender, and even being described as like a fixer and somebody, you know, who would, if you complained about the governor, she would be the one who would go, nah, this is BS and you don't know what you're talking about. And now she's had enough, apparently. She's had enough, and it's not like she said anything specific. that would help us understand why now she's resigning. It was one of those generic, it's been an honor to serve the people of New York for the last 10 years, blah, blah, blah. No, I think it's got to be because it's now too hot to be that connected to Governor Cuomo. If the impeachment in New York kind of works like it does federally, which is the lower house would pass articles of impeachment and then it goes over to the state Senate for a trial. If the lower house passes the articles, though, the way New York law works, at that moment, he has to hand over the reins of power to the lieutenant governor. They don't wait till you're convicted in the Senate. So it's really, really likely that very soon she's going to be the new governor of New York. And here's the thing. Cuomo, even at his best, very divisive guy. Now reviled widely across the whole state. Kathy Hochul, beloved. She has been in politics for years, at least since the mid-80s. She is consistently described as being professional, hardworking, good temperament, and seems to really like meeting people and meeting constituents. And I'll tell you what, she has been a busy bee. Here's an example of her schedule. This is one random example of a week's schedule for this person. Two appearances in Brooklyn, one in Manhattan, four different appearances up in Niagara Falls, one in some place called Lockport, another one in some place called Pendleton, three appearances that week in Buffalo, four in Rochester, two in Binghamton, and another one in some place called Cortland. I mean, and she, every year, she visits every county in the state. So you're talking about, like, if there's a good example of a career politician, it's her. And she's about to take over. And it's honestly, it really is just a matter of when. And good for her that all this time that she was a lieutenant governor, she never got in tight. She can never be accused of being an enabler or an excuse maker or anything else. Get a news update from Jennifer Jones Lee, please. And then I want to tell you, it is a true crime story. A guy kills his cellmate. But wait till you hear why. It's KFI AM 640 live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app.
The fire burning in Butte, Plumas, Lassen, and Tehama counties in Northern California is now the second largest in state history. The fire has burned almost 500,000 acres and has destroyed hundreds of homes. But by mail ballots for the September 14th California governor's race are expected to arrive in mailboxes soon. And August 8th is now officially Tom Flores Day in Riverside County. Yesterday's date was picked to commemorate the day the legendary Raiders coach was inducted into the Pro Football Hall of Fame. We've got a look at your ride with the KFI in the Sky and the 405 next.
Are you one of millions of people across the country thinking about retiring earlier than expected? Join us on Tuesday, August 17th at 3 p.m. or 8 p.m. Eastern for our brand new virtual event for you called 9 Wealth Strategies. You will get our 9 strategies that can help protect your wealth and plan your income. Register for free at EdelmanFinancialEngines.com. Your wealth and ultimately your legacy face 3 risks: rising taxes, inflation, and healthcare costs. At our special virtual event called 9 Wealth Strategies, you'll get advice on how to help protect your wealth from these risks. Our advice is based on 30 plus years of experience and managing more than $270 billion. Please join us for this special virtual event, 9 Wealth Strategies, on Tuesday, August 17th at 3 p.m. or 8 p.m. Eastern. See how to do 3 things: manage your wealth, minimize taxes, and plan your income in retirement. Go to EdelmanFinancialEngines.com to register for free. That's EdelmanFinancialEngines.com. From here forward.
Discover matches all the cash back you earn on your credit card at the end of your first year. It's amazing because Discover is accepted at 99% of places in the U.S. that take credit cards. Learn more at discover.com/yes. 2021 Nielsen report limitations apply.
SoCal weather from KFI, mostly sunny with highs from the upper 60s to the upper 90s. This report is brought to you by Discover. Let's look at that drive on the 405.
The infamous 405. Now, leaving the San Fernando Valley, it's not really all that bad. It is definitely stop and stop from Victory Boulevard through the interchange up and over the hill down to about Sunset Boulevard. But then things will improve, so it's not really that bad. Eastbound 101 now coming out of Gore Hills into the San Fernando Valley. It's okay. It stays that way. Maybe a little slow from receiving through the 405. And the other way around now, West 134 getting out of Burbank over towards Toluca Lake. Getting slow a little bit before Cahuenga over to the 170-101. Driving to Long Beach, now if you just joined us, it's a long claim problem, but South 710 from the 105 all the way into the harbor is just getting slower and slower. Most of the problem, traffic of course, but PCH off-ramps from the South 710 still shut down due to a long plane Long Beach PD investigation going on for a while. Baldwin Park, southbound 710 and Ramona before the 10, a little bit of a shoulder problem there. But the slowest section, definitely from the 605 down to the 105. And quickly, I'll follow up on this next time around. Orange County going into Irvine, south 5 at Culver Boulevard. Some center divider activity slowing you down from the 55. Injured in an accident, visit Superwoman, superlawyer.com. KFI, get you there faster. I'm Jeff Baugh.
This report is sponsored by Spectrum Business. Small businesses, you may be paying twice what you should for internet and phone, but there's good news. Switch to Spectrum Business and get faster internet speeds and proven reliability for half what you're paying now. Call Spectrum Business at 888-489-2212 today.
I now know how naive I was when we decided to sell our first house. I thought all you did was call the realtor, and they, I don't know, told you patch this up and, nail this in and go fix up the backyard. And that was it, right? Oh, I was so wrong. There was so much work that we had to do, and I didn't know that there was a company out there that would help take all that stress away from selling your home, and that company is Open Door. See, Open Door is going to smooth all those rough edges of selling a home so you don't have to do the repairs yourself. You don't have to do the prep work or deal with all those showings. All you do is log on to opendoor.com, answer a few questions about your house. They compare your information to comps in the neighborhood and come up with a real competitive offer. So sell your home the new-fashioned way at opendoor.com. Offer eligibility varies. Open Door is represented by Open Door Brokerage, Inc., license number 02061130 in California, and Open Door Brokerage, LLC in its other markets. Sell your home the new-fashioned way. Go to opendoor.com/myoffer.
Summer fun rolls on at San Manuel Casino. Every Thursday in August, San Manuel is giving away a 2021 Maserati Ghibli Trofeo or up to $100,000 in cash. That's right, you could drive away in a new car or cash each week. Earn entries using your Club Serrano card each time you play, and you could be one of our lucky grand prize winners. Catch the thrills all month long at SoCal's number one casino, San Manuel. Details at sanmanuel.com. Must be 21. Please gamble responsibly.
Hi, this is Kevin LeCrette, iHeartMedia president for the Los Angeles region. The last year and a half have tested everyone's resolve. At iHeartMedia, we have trusted our friends at Coit Cleaning and Restoration to clean our personal homes and offices. As we move into the next few months, don't forget to keep your home and workplace sanitized. Do what we did. Call the pros at Coit Cleaning and Restoration at 1-800-4-COIT. That's 1-800-F-O-R-C-O-I-T. Or schedule your appointment today at coit.com.
This week at Riverside in Huntington Beach, Harley, buy any pre-owned Harley and get a $1,500 gift card. That's 50 pennies. For California's largest Harley inventory, Riverside in Huntington Beach, Harley has truckloads of Harleys delivered each week. Get a $1,500 gift card with the purchase of any pre-owned Harley at Riverside and Huntington Beach, Harley. That's a Kroger 5 penny. Finance specialists on-site to get you approved and 100% of credit applications considered. Get a $1,500 gift card when you purchase any pre-owned Harley at Riverside in Huntington Beach, Harley. Now through Sunday.
The car can be used for the purchase of a new Harley motorcycle.
Homeowners, you hear the news every day. Rates go up and rates go down.
While the economy struggles to recover, rising inflation rears its ugly head. Stop banging your head against a wall. Mortgage rates are again at all-time lows. That's right. Rates are at all-time lows. Put a bit of cash back in your pocket with a refi from True Mortgage. Get a 15-year fixed at just 1.75%, 2.140% APR. Even better, True Mortgage will cover your title, escrow, and appraisal fees. Qualification is fast and simple. Keep more of your hard-earned money and boost your savings. Lock in a lifetime of true value today with the lowest rates ever offered at 800-620-1162. That's 800-620-1162. 800-620-1162. Or visit TrueNow.com.
Sign on the Lightning DBA True Mortgage is an equal housing lender. Terms and conditions apply. All loans subject to underwriting approval and not all applicants will qualify. Loans made or arranged pursuant to a California Finance Law License Number 60-DBO-44713 and NMLS Number
1626699. Win your way to our 2021 iHeart Radio Music Festival, September 17th and 18th in Las Vegas. And win $1,000. You'll see
Billie Eilish,
Cheap Trick,
Coldplay,
Dua Lipa,
Florida Georgia Line,
J. Cole,
Journey,
Khalid,
Lil Baby,
Maroon 5,
Nelly,
Sam Hunt,
Weezer, special guest performance by Phineas,
and more on the T-Mobile Arena stage in Las Vegas. Listen every weekday to win your way there and win $1,000.
Gavin Newsom's a thief.
Yeah, he's a thief.
And the reason he has to steal the power is because he's incompetent.
We have 36% solar and wind energy now.
That's too much reliance on that because it runs out at the end of the day.
John and Ken.
Nobody has a crane and a pulley to try to lift the sun back up over the horizon for a little while.
We pay the two on KFI.
AM 640 live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app. It's a Bill Handel show. Bill, as you probably know, is recovering from the replacement heart valve surgery, and we'll get an update on how he's doing. Don't know if he can be on the phone necessarily, but one way or another, we will let you know how it's going with him at 9 o'clock. And there's going to be a chance around 9:20 or so for you to win a trip for two to the iHeart Music Festival. This is airfare, it is hotel, it is ground transportation. I always feel bad for ground transportation. Just because when you have a prize package and you start listing the stuff, ground transportation always is the one where nobody, you know, airfare, hotel for two nights, two tickets to both nights of the iHeart Music Festival and the day stage on Saturday, and ground transportation. Eh. But it's part of it, and $1,000. That's coming up about 9:20 this morning. Oh, this story, man. If you like true crime stuff, I think you're going to like this story. I'm not saying it's a happy story. It's not a happy story. There's a guy named Shane Goldsby. He's 26 years old, and he just got sentenced to 25 years in prison for killing his cellmate in the prison. What happened? Well, here's what happened. Shane Goldsby is in his prison cell. They come in and say, "You got a new cellmate." Here comes this guy. He's 70 years old. His name is Robert Munger. He's just picked up 43 years in prison for child molestation, possession of child pornography. And Robert Munger, the older guy, starts talking about his crime. Talking about what he did to the victims. Talking about how he took photos of what he did to the victims and took videos of what he did to the victims. And Shane Goldsby doesn't want to hear this. And there's a very particular reason that Shane Goldsby doesn't want to hear about this. I mean, you shouldn't ever want to hear about this. But Shane Goldsby has a specific reason that he doesn't want to hear about this. Because the victim that Robert Munger is talking about and the things that he did to her and the pictures that he took of her, that victim Shane Goldsby's sister. So Goldsby says that he asked repeatedly to be moved to a different cell. Now, the Department of Corrections in Washington says, no, he never did. He never asked to be moved. He says he asked to be moved a bunch of times. What is undisputed is he wasn't moved. So one day, I guess he's had enough. He's had enough of sharing a cell with the guy who raped his sister. He's certainly had enough of this guy yakking about it. And so they're in a common area at the correctional center. He sneaks up behind him. He knocks him down. He stomps on his head many times. And Munger goes to the hospital. Munger is dead a few days later. So now Shane Goldsby gets 25 years in prison. And the prosecutor said they wanted a long enough sentence. Think about where their sympathies are here for a second. They wanted a long enough sentence so that the other guy, the rapist's wife, would be dead, just from old age, would be dead before Shane Goldsby had any chance of getting out of prison. In other words, trying to spare the wife of the child rapist the emotional agony of years from now learning that the guy who killed her husband, the child rapist, is eligible to get out of prison. So the big question is, how did this happen? How did they end up putting a guy who raped a young girl in the same cell as the brother of the young girl that he raped? And you know what? The Department of Corrections said, we did everything correctly. They're supposed to do a segregation analysis to keep either you know, someone who is likely to be an aggressor or a victim of an aggressor or in some other way a threat to the orderly running of the prison and keep them separated. And it didn't happen here. But here's the thing. It's hard to know whether they messed up or not, because part of the problem is Goldsby and his sister have different last names. So it's not clear whether they could even have known about the connection. But in any event, that is what went down. And some guy said, a state senator up there is trying to look into how this all happened. He said of the child rapist, 70-year-old child rapist, he probably would have died in prison, but he shouldn't have had to die like that. News update from Jennifer Jones Lee right now. And then people are going out and getting vaccine shots they're not supposed to be getting. I thought we were mad at the people who should get a vaccine shot and aren't getting it. Now I have to be mad at people who are getting too many vaccine shots also. Oh, the list of people I gotta be mad at. It's KFI AM 640 live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app.
What you need to know and when you need to know it.
KFI.
And KOST HD2.
Los Angeles, Orange County.
Live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app.
Following a spike, I'm Jennifer Jones Lee, live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. Cases of COVID-19 in LA County have spiked over the weekend.
The highest in 6 months, but the daily positivity rate dipped a bit. A week ago, it was 6%, and as of yesterday, it dropped to 4.3%. County health officials say hospitalizations continue to climb. 1,433 people are being treated for the virus, most all of whom are unvaccinated. A week ago, the number was 1,096. Women now have the highest number of cases at 636,000 versus men at 596,000. Deaths have also dipped a bit. The highest death rate is among Hispanics, followed by whites, Asians, then blacks. Steve Gregory, KFI News.
The head of the American Federation of Teachers says getting vaccinated against COVID-19 is a community responsibility.
And it weighs really heavily on me that kids under 12 can't get vaccinated.
AFT President Randy Weingarten says she's also in favor of requiring vaccines for teachers. She says the information about the vaccine being put out by some officials like Florida Governor DeSantis and Texas Governor Abbott is harming communities. Weingarten says there are teachers in her union who do not want to come back to school for the new year if mask mandates aren't in place. Canada has reopened its border with the U.S. Americans who have been vaccinated can now cross the border to shop, visit, or take a vacation. The border's been closed to non-essential travel since March last year due to the pandemic. The U.S. says Canadians won't be able to come across for non-essential trips until at least August 21st. Police in Long Beach say they shot a driver who led them on a chase that started in Signal Hill. Police say the person was wanted for an armed robbery. They say he crashed his car on PCH last night. An officer shot him when he got out of the car. Paramedics were called to take the man to the hospital. A report by the United Nations Climate Panel warns the impact of human-caused climate change are severe and widespread. Vice Chair of the panel, Co Barrett, says global warming will continue to be felt for centuries, but she also says it's not too late to turn things around.
It tells us that recent changes in the climate are widespread, rapid, and intensifying, unprecedented for thousands of years.
The report says Earth's climate is getting so hot that temperatures in about a decade will probably blow past a level of warming that world leaders have tried to prevent. President Biden says the hearts of Americans have swelled with pride seeing U.S. Olympians do so well in Tokyo. Biden and the First Lady have heaped praise on the athletes for their accomplishments and for setting a good example for their fellow Americans. The president says the athletes handled themselves with grace and decency. And the co-founder of Cool and the Gang has died. Dennis D.T. Thomas died in his sleep Saturday. Thomas played the alto sax, flute, and had been a percussionist. He also acted as the MC of the band's shows. Cool and the Gang earned 2 Grammy Awards and won 7 American Music Awards. Dennis Thomas was 70. Let's take a look at your drive on the 5 through Orange County.
Wow, I can't tell you how many times I've played that song in the clubs. Boy, oh boy, I'm missing. Yeah, it's quite a problem now. Driving through Irvine, South 5 Culver Drive has been an instant work in the center divider for quite a long time, actually. And it's really getting south, coming out coming out from the 22. Now, a major problem working in Marina Valley now. It's just kind of South 215, East 60, merge split and all that at Central. Red Box Springs Road, 3 drivers tangle. It's really a mess. Got a whole bunch of lanes blocked. East 215 stops at the 91. Long time delays if you get stuck in that. The East 10 going through Redlands is wide open. And a problem in the Newhall Pass, South 14 to 5. Always a tough spot. There's been a crash there. The South 14 already slow, but really now stopping a little bit south of Newhall Avenue. Using Tierra Highway down towards the Emerge is still a pretty good drive. Now, if you heard Jen talking about that Long Beach PD incident in Long Beach, South 710, because of that, the Pacific Coast Highway off-ramps are still shut down. It's adding to delays. Continue down to Anaheim Street, and you can get off the freeway there. Injured in an accident, visit superwoman.com. KFI gets you there faster. I'm Jeff Baugh.
If you're self-employed and you've been denied by those traditional lenders for a home loan or a refi, listen to this. Equinox Home Financing is the answer for the self-employed because you do not deserve to be penalized for being an entrepreneur. Here's what they can do. They can use personal or business bank statements for income instead of tax returns. Conventional lenders cannot. Call 855-LOAN-455, 855-LOAN-455, or go to EquinoxHomeFinancing.com. That's EquinoxHomeFinancing.com.
Hey, it's Gary Hoffman. Let's talk about your Medicare coverage. SCAN Health Plan is for people with Medicare. Now more than ever, it's important to have comprehensive coverage when you need it most. If you're new to Medicare, have both Medicare and Medi-Cal, or have been diagnosed with certain chronic conditions, you may qualify to enroll in SCAN now. Call SCAN at 1-855-370-7226, TTY711, or ask your agent about SCAN.
SCAN Health Plan is an HMO plan with a Medicare contract. Enrollment in SCAN Health Plan depends on contract renewal.
Your KFI Financial Report is brought to you by Bay Alarm. The Dow is down 109, S&P down 2, NASDAQ up 23, and the average price of a gallon of unleaded gas in California is $4.39.
The KFI Money Report is brought to you by Bay Alarm. Protect your business with a monitored video verification system. Visit bayalarm.com to get protected today.
SoCal weather from KFI. We've got a mostly sunny day ahead. Temperatures will range from the upper 60s to low 70s at the beaches. We'll be in the 80s for Orange County and Metro LA. We'll make it into the 90s for the valleys in the IE, and we could see some triple digits back by middle of the week. Right now it's 67 in Tustin, 66 in Orange, 68 right here in Burbank. We lead local, live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. I'm Jennifer Jones-Lee.
KFI AM 640. Live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app. Good morning, Bill Handel Show. Bill recovering from heart valve surgery. We'll get an update at 9 o'clock. And about 20 after 9, your chance to win a trip for two to the iHeart Music Festival, plus $1,000 on top of that. Hey, get vaccinated. I don't want to. You're bad. Fair enough, by the way. Absolutely fair enough, and I agree with that. I'm not down with the UBCs out there. Don't like you UBCs. Unvaccinated by choice. UBC. Don't want it. Don't want it. You're bumming us out. I'm not, it's not that I'm trying to invalidate your reasons. What I'm saying is this is something you should just get over. But now, I'm not concerned with you at the moment because we got a new problem with people and getting vaccinations, and those are people running around getting booster shots that you're not supposed to be getting. We know that the FDA is looking at issuing some kind of approval for booster shots for some people, right? And Dr. Fauci said, yes, maybe immunocompromised people will get a booster shot, but regular folk, there doesn't seem to be booster shots on the horizon, at least not in the United States. Now, in Israel, they are doing booster shots, but not here, not yet, maybe not ever. So who is getting, I don't want to say illegal, because it's not clear to me what the law has to say about it, so I will say illicit. Who's getting illicit booster shots out there? Who's going to the booster shot speakeasy and the little window slides open, and you have to know the code? Is the purple mushroom ripe? The thing closes. You hear like click, click, clash, click, clong. It's like 15 deadbolts being turned, and then you get to go in and you get your, and then it's just people all laying around. It's like an opium den, except it's people getting booster shots of the vaccine, right? Anyway, oh, there's some good mental imagery for you. Who is it? It is primarily right now people who got the Johnson & Johnson shot. And this is a psychology I can completely understand.